To be a college athlete, you need to make sacrifices. You need to devote your time and energy all year round to your sport, in addition to academics. Sports are an emotional experience that entails many highs and lows in the pursuit of growth and victory. That ride can bring times of joy and celebration, and times of tears and hardship. For many, that roller coaster is worth it to compete at the Division I level for the coaches and teammates that you love. Unfortunately for most things in 2020, the pandemic has plunged our world into uncertainty, with implications still being assessed a year later. For this story, we'll be following the journeys of several Sacred Heart University athletes and how their mental health has intertwined with their sport, and how COVID-19 has forced them to confront these challenges to adapt to the new normal. Although the scoreboard is unpredictable, student athletes know what to expect week in, week out. Class, lift, meeting, practice, game, repeat. A former college athlete, Kathleen Early, the athletic mental health counselor at Sacred Heart, understands how COVID-19 has disrupted that routine.
I think the pandemic has, really played such a big role this year, obviously, and I think specifically, even more so for athletes. Now they've had to put seasons on pause, or seasons have been changed from maybe the fall to the spring, and so I think what they're normally sort of used to or feel secure in, which is, having practices and games and really having a routine and a schedule, has completely changed and shifted for them.
I deal with anxiety problems, and having COVID be something that you have to constantly think about and worry about has definitely not made it any easier. I really like things being on a schedule, and I know my whole team does as well. Everything being kind of changed and playing it week by week is something that I'm personally not a fan of, so having to adjust to that has been a lot of effort and work.
At first I was man, no football in the fall. Then I was man, I might not ever play a football game again. And that is when it hit me that I have no idea what's gonna happen down the road. I have no idea if I'm playing a game. So all I can do is take it day by day. If they tell me to lift, I'm gonna lift. If they tell me to practice, I'm gonna practice. They say be ready for games, I'm gonna be ready for games. But as far as the outlook, I might never play a game again, and that's just the way the world goes.
SHU Basketball's Zach Pfaffenberger recognizes the uncertainty that COVID brings to a team firsthand, as he tested positive for COVID.
I think it's put it into more of a perspective for the players. I think we're more cautious now, even though we were before, but now it kind of just shows you, even if you're doing what you need to do and doing things correctly, you could still possibly get it, and it could easily happen to anybody.
The schedule of a college athlete can be overwhelming, and with so much left uncertain, it can be challenging for athletes to stay motivated.
They're normally excited about that game on the weekend, or the practice during the week, and now all of a sudden, with so many pauses being put on their seasons and uncertainty to when even their next game will be, I've seen that a lot of student athletes have struggled to find that motivation because they're just unsure of what's to come.
Getting out of bed might suck, but the conditioning they will make you do if you're late is a million times worse. So that fear factor gets me moving a little bit.
At first, it was definitely hard because, we're grinding 5 days a week and there's no games. And so in the back of my head, I would kind of be well, what is this for? Why am I doing this? Practice Monday to Friday, 2.5 hours a day. And then, you throw on 3 hours of lift a week to that. Sometimes I would definitely get annoyed. I would tell myself, this doesn't matter.
It was especially challenging for incoming freshmen to buy into an athletic program at a new school under unusual circumstances. Freshman football player Ernest Howard found comfort in his close circle of support to find motivation.
For family and friends, it just made me closer to them, checking up on them, because you never know what's going to happen with COVID. It was hard, just doing at-home workouts, just still being motivated to get up and get it every day.
For athletes, having coaches who lay out structure and accountability can help push them through adversity.
I think when coaches hold a standard, like this is how my players play, and they hold you to it, I think that's something that really, whether you're paying attention to it or not, it's something that's always there, the standard. And if you're not hitting it, they'll let you know. And it kind of allows you to figure out where you're supposed to be. But also that coach has to have belief in you and faith in you. It's bigger than just an individual game, and having that belief really resonates and inspires you to play for someone other than yourself. Defense says it every time. We play for Coach Cook.
My name is Mike Cook. I'm the defensive coordinator for Sacred Heart University, and I'm from Brooklyn, New York.
I reached out to a few of your defensive players just to get some of their favorite things about you, and I got this video from Omar.
Oh, man.
My favorite thing about Coach Cook is, number one, he's a competitor. Whether he's Saturday when he's getting us hyped up for a game, or at practice Tuesday, Wednesday, an inside run, or even if we're just playing pickup at the Bobby V, you know, he's going to give it his all. He's going to do everything in his power to make sure that his team comes out successful and the other team loses. And number two is just his honesty. He doesn't sugarcoat anything. He just tells you what he thinks. He tells you the truth, and he tells you how you need to get better, what you need to do to improve, what you're not doing, how you're hurting the team.
I also had something from Chris Abridge. He didn't send a video because he said he needed to get a cut really bad. But
oh, my God, Chris.
I know. I gave him about it. Here's what Chris had to say. My favorite things about Cook are his sense of humor and his ability to connect with players from all different walks of life and guide them in the right direction. Tell me how this affirmation feels from your players.
Well, it feels good. It lets me know that what I'm doing is the right thing. You know, I chose the right path as far as coaching. And my biggest thing is being upfront, honest, and self-humility. Like, I'm the same way. If I'm having a bad day, or if I'm making bad calls or something like that within the game, I let the guys know. It's always on me, but I will stand up in front of everybody and say, yo, that's on me. That's a bad decision by me. And I think that honesty that I guess I bring, that which Omar said, it helps lead to comfortability with everybody. And as far as Outer Bridge, you know, that meant a lot too. Andrew O'Neill kind of said the same thing to me a week ago, which is kind of crazy. He said, you know, you're a good motivator for kids that don't have anything and for kids that are privileged like myself. You know, you motivate us to be better people, and you show us how the right way to do it. And we appreciate that. And, you know, I appreciate them thinking of me as more than just a coach. I'm not just a coach to those guys.
I tell Coach Cook everything. Life, football. That's probably why I chose here.
It's something deeper, and that's why I think our team is so close, because it's much more than just coaches and players and wins and losses with us.
My coaches have done so much for me over the years off the field. They've taught me how to be confident, be independent. Like, I used to be somebody who was so shy and timid, and I would be like afraid to give presentations and afraid to speak up. And now, you know, I'm someone who's a leader on the team, and I speak up in the classroom everywhere. I'm not afraid to, you know, vocalize things that I'm passionate about.
Change is hard for anybody. For student athletes, the transition to college can impact their own sense of identity, which adds to their stress and anxiety.
Athletics has always been such a big part of their life. So when, you know, they're in high school, most of them, you know, usually are like one of the best on their team. And when they come to college, I think it then becomes a new adjustment. It's difficult for them to find their place right away. It also creates difficulty finding their way, you know, in a new space.
It's funny because in high school, you know, I didn't have problems with my mental health once I started playing rugby, because rugby's always been the thing that kind of grounded me and made me, you know, feel comfortable, and it was nice being a part of a team. And then the transition to D1 was very hard for me. Freshman year, I was known for being like that girl who was anxious, that girl who cried during practices. Like, my teammates were actually talking about it with me today. Like, we were laughing because I used to be the girl that would just walk off the field during practice to stand by the fence and cry because I was so anxious, or because, you know, my asthma was out of control. And then I would like get into a panic attack and I would just like stand there trying to control my breathing. And that whole first semester, I struggled mentally. You know, I wanted to quit every single day. I would show up to practice every day and either in my head or to my coach be like, yeah, like I'm still thinking about quitting. Like, I don't know if I want to be here. It's really hard.
Sometimes you need a helping hand to find strength.
I've grown a lot since then. And the thing that helped me change it was a lot of mindset, but also my coach. One of the practices, you know, one of the conditionings after I was crying, my assistant coach looked at me and, you know, she could tell something was wrong in that, like, I was full to say I had to throw up. Like, she could tell I was upset. And she talked to me and then, you know, she took me out for lunch a week later. And that's what really started our relationship, you know, and then I got close to Coach Reed as well after that. And getting closer to them really helped me because when I was struggling in the summer, when I was questioning returning to Sacred Heart, I called my assistant coach, Coach Solomon, and she's the reason I came back. And the freshmen on my team now, they would never think that the person I was freshman year is who I am now. You know, they would never recognize that person. And they hear some stories about it, especially like if they see what I've written in mud, and they just can't even believe that it's me. So that personal growth has been huge for me, and I'm happy to see myself kind of like from day one to now.
The Pitt Center is where Division I athletes call home. When COVID-19 affected protocol, it felt more like an empty house than a home.
The Pitt Center is weird now. Pitt Center is a ghost town. You walk down the hallways of the Pitt and it might just be you and you only. Practices are different. You got to wear the masks. We're not allowed to high five and celebrate. Like, lifting's odd because there's certain things you can't do in the weight room anymore. Certain people I can't interact with on the field because they're outside of my group of people I work out with. I don't know what to say other than it's so different. It's like a 180 spin.
The strict nature of COVID protocol emphasized safety, but weakened some of those personal connections between players.
We were able to kind of go in like smaller groups. In terms of that, like, you can get more things done. It's more structured. It's everything is bang, bang, bang. It's just more reps, everything like that. It's definitely hurt because of how we had to break up into our pods. So we broke up pods, infield, outfield, pitchers, catchers. But some of the outfielders needed to work in the infield. But you can't break that pod. So it kind of hurts in terms of like getting work, or you might have to pull someone out of their pod for the whole day and then they can't switch back and forth as easily. I think it's helped individual, but in terms of like a full team, I think it's kind of like hurt the chemistry.
COVID-19 has also challenged the coaching and administrative process at SHU.
It's been so difficult on the coaching staff. It's something new every day. With scheduling, with conference, because, you know, we don't know what's going to happen.
For the spring, like with the fall sports, playing, like the football team's only playing like 4 games. I feel like they're almost not understanding how it affects the school. How are they going to put the football team on the football field and the men's lacrosse team and the women's lacrosse team? And all these teams like have to use these facilities.
We already worked out the logistics. We won't be playing any time that anybody else is playing. We're going to be playing on Sundays. People don't realize it, but we weren't playing games in the springs, but we were still sharing the fields. So it wasn't a football's here and now you can't have the fields. Like, no, we'll just use these 2 hours, use the next 2 hours. I think our school has done a great job of organizing who's going to go when and where. And the NEC obviously chose Sundays because that would also help mitigate interactions with other teams as far as their schedules.
Although this experience has been difficult, athletes found silver linings and reflected on the lessons learned in their personal journeys.
Being a student athlete back in my day, I'm so used to going at such a fast pace. And I think that this pandemic has really taught me really pushed me to kind of slow down and to recognize that it's okay to slow down and just to learn better ways to be able to cope with the uncertainties.
Always come in positive, ready to, you know, work and get better, no matter if it's in sports or it's in your career field and things like that. There's so many uncertainties in life, and be thankful for the situations that you have and for the opportunities that you are given in front of you, because there's a lot of people in this world that, you know, might have it worse than you do personally. So just be thankful for the things that are given to you, and don't take things for granted.
professionally, I think I've learned that the students that I work with are so resilient. I have felt, you know, just immense pride to be a part of their journey, to see how creative they are, to even come up with ways to stay connected to each other.
It definitely has been hard trying to study film on Zoom and stuff like that, but it comes with time. Just focusing on the bigger picture, you know. The Zoom calls is hard and stuff like that, but it's going to help later down the road when we play.
Although I'm not playing, this time is going to be really great to build connections with the freshmen, for all of us to learn how to play together and, you know, to build that team chemistry.
Athletes have been able to reflect on the discipline and life lessons their teams have taught them over the years and how it will help them beyond college.
Sacred Heart and rugby, this team has taught me so many skills that I'm going to take away from. And it's not just about being a good rugby player. They've taught me how to literally function as a person, how to go after things that I want, you know, that confidence, that assertiveness, but also things like time management, discipline, motivation, and mental toughness.
I think just like working in a stressful environment and getting things done when they need to be has definitely been like a really big life lesson.
It's definitely hard. No one's gonna tell you like being a D1 athlete's easy, but if you stick it out, there are so many benefits beyond just improving your athletic performance. And I think that some people sometimes overlook that. So the whole experience has definitely been life-changing for me.
I think they've taught me so much throughout this year, and it's just been, you know, such an amazing experience to be a small part of their journey throughout this year in particular, because I've learned so much from them as well.